Hi everyone, in this video we are going to talk about a new kind of box plot. And my friend, she is a biologist, she asked me to help her draw this graph today. And I was thinking this is a very nice graph and I want to make up some data so we can also draw the graph here all together. So I'm going to save this data as a dataset on my desktop, and the value I'm going to name it as crab data. So you can see I just saved it as an Excel file and I saved it. So now I'm going to open my RStudio to import this data. So I click R script, and then I open a new R script, and now I'm going to import the data set that I just created. The data set is on my desktop, it is here, and I just click to open it. So you can also get a nice data preview here showing the variables we have, the values we have. So you can click import and the data will be imported like this. So the first thing here is to install .packages of ggplot2 if you haven't done so before. But I have installed it, so I just load that package and use the functions called ggplot. So to make sure next time when I open the dataset, I have the data readily available. So I just copied everything in the console to the top so that I can just run those lines to load my dataset, and I can also view the dataset. So now I'm going to type ggplot from the ggplot2 package. The dataset name, I just double click and paste it here. And then the aesthetic information, the x-axis will be the different crabs. So I will let it to be species, y equals the weight, and this is to identify the before and after. So this is the variable named as stage. And then I can just use the geometric objects, which is boxplot, and I can run these two lines now. So you can see it here. If you zoom that picture, you can see there is a nice picture showing before and after, and also showing you like blue crabs, mud crabs, and spider crabs. One thing you may notice, and it may bother you, is that the after is placed in front of before, which is a concern. So what we can do here is to make a little bit change before you draw the graph. So we can actually change the stage and make it a factor, find the levels for it. So the levels, there will be two. So the first one is before, and the second one will be after, and you want it to be ordered. So ordered equals true, that means you really want the order to be before first, and then after later. And you can run that line. It will give you the graph here, and you can see before is placed in the first place and after, the yellow is placed after the before, which is the right order. And if you don't like the colors we have here, we can actually specify the colors for before and after. Skill fill menu, which means you are going to manually assign the values. and that values are going to assigned according to the before and after, and the values will be like if you want blue and orange, you can do that by assigning the blue and orange in the values. And if we run this, you can see you get a blue and orange combination. Like if you are trying to do this for a journal, you may want it less colorful, which means you can do gray and black. And you may also want to change the theme of the picture. So you can do theme classic, and then you can run those lines. And you will see a less colorful graph, but still looks very professional. See?